You see, when you realize you are so abundant in love and you are one with everything, that is a very powerful thing. You will never feel lonely in that sense. But then beyond that, because you have everything, the things we would say, health and wealth and all this, no problem there. Okay? Let me tell you something. The only thing to fulfill your highest need will be highest purpose. The question you have to ask yourself going forward is, okay, what can I embark on that I can start making a huge contribution to this world? That's the next step for you. Let me ask everybody a question. A person who is financially free, are they enlightened enough to teach so many people or educate or help so many people out of their situations? Yes or no? Okay. That alone. Don't even say financially free. Let's say you're not financially free. A person who is having a happy relationship with their partner, are they enlightened enough to help thousands, if not millions of people in this world have a happy relationship? Yes or no? Giving some guidance. Yeah? They can. All these are different things. So many different things. You say, yeah, but what? No, I don't mean that type of enlightenment. I mean when my third eye opens. That's next thing. But let me tell you something. If you are by yourself and you're feeling lonely, don't know why, something's missing. If this physical is this way, why would energies or universe assist you for third eye opening right now? Because that is giving you even more things to deal with. People who ask what their purpose is, they say, how do I find my purpose? My usual first response is this, what skills do you have? People are like, no, what do you mean? I'm saying, what is my purpose? I said, no, what skills do you have? They say, no, but I want to know my purpose, you know? I'm saying, yeah, but your purpose depends on what skills you have. You're like, huh? How does that work? Grandmaster Akshar, he always says to people, he said, your way to find your purpose, equip yourself first, then you'll find your purpose. Let me put it this way. Okay, people often say, they say, why were you chosen by Grandmaster Akshar? I say, actually, Eric Ho's vessel was very equipped. He was not a shy kid. He knew how to communicate. He knew how to reach out to masses. Not only that, he knew how to convert. He knew how to conversate. He knew how to, not only that, he had love and positivity. This is what he wants to do. Right? Not only that, he knows what it takes to succeed. Right? He has all these skills. There's a level of consciousness where people will say, love, let's spread the word of love, consciousness, and then we'll heal the whole world. Okay. Sorry to break it. It will never happen that everything is positive. You can't get positive without negative. You will never know anger without happiness. You will never know happiness without sadness. You get what I'm saying? We live in a world of duality. There is no hate without love. There's no love without hate. So actually the world will always be duality. I think, so what's the point? Yeah. Your point is to be the balance. You choose which side are you going to balance out. You're going to balance out the negative or you're going to balance out the positive. So what does this mean? Look at science. This is not universe and woo-woo talk and religion. This is science. You learn? Protons, neutrons, electrons, you learn? Everything's about balance. That's existence. You look at a person who's alive, hook them onto a machine, what does it look like? When it's flat line, only one line. One line, love line. It doesn't matter what line it is, positivity line. It doesn't matter what line. One line, flat line, finish. Existence ceases. Energy moves, it has to move in waves. It means there's always positive and negative, right? So if we look at it like that, think about it. Universe has a couple of responsibilities. First responsibility, make sure everything is in balance. There's not overwhelm of negativity. There's not overwhelm of positivity. Make sure everything is in balance. You think, what do they mean? You, as much as their channel, the whole, okay, maybe you don't like the word universe because you're relating to God and you don't want to think God is bad or anything like that. Okay, that's fine. I don't want you to think that way. Okay, let's not use the word universe in this example. Just use the word existence, meaning all energies. Okay. Now, if you were the gatekeeper of all energies, you will distribute 50% towards positivity, 50% towards negativity. And it needs to manifest in physical reality. When it manifests in physical reality, what will you be doing? You will be finding positive vessels to spread a positive message. Will you not? Okay, will you just find, let me ask you a question. Will you find the most loving, unequipped vessels to be the leader to spread positivity? You will not. I don't care how big your heart is. You don't have the capacity. You have no tools. You have one reach. You reach out to you and you yourself. You're not going to, even if I give you all the powers, you can't reach out to anybody. Your vessel is not ready. Right? In the same sense, actually, negativity is working the same way. Negativity is channeling energy through positive. You tell me people who are leading wars. You tell me these leaders who are leading gangs and wars and things like that. You tell me they're not strong vessel? They're a strong vessel. Let me tell you something. A lot of these leaders, gang leaders, whatever leaders, they're much more equipped than you are. They know how to. But the interesting thing is this. Very similar traits, different intention. I don't know if you realized that before. Similar traits, different intention. Have you ever watched things like, anybody ever watched Pablo Escobar here? Anybody ever watched that? Right? Let me tell you, these are very strong entrepreneurship traits. Different intention. Actually, leaders all have similar traits. Leaders, they're strong, they're determined, they'll get stuff done. They're equipped with communication skills. They know how to communicate something. They know how to get people to do things. They know how to lead people. They know how to recruit people. This is what all leaders do, whether it's negative or positive. The only thing that sets apart is intention. Now, so it's very simple. People are like, okay, why won't my third eye open? Why won't they choose me? When will I be given higher powers and higher things to do? Well, first of all, my question to you is this. What's your CV? How equipped are you? If you were universe, would you pick you? Looking at where you're at and what you do, think about it. I'm lonely. Universe says, that's the perfect leader to choose. Let's open up that third eye, give them more responsibilities and serve a greater purpose. It will not happen that way. Do you get what I'm saying? When this strength is here, it's almost like people, like, imagine this. Imagine I have a workplace. It's a marketing company, let's say. Right? What's your name, sir?
Me.
Yeah.
James.
Imagine James comes for the job. I say to him, okay, James, you got the job. He asked me, okay, so how do I make myself purposeful here? I say, what are your skills, James? James says, I don't have any. If you were me, what jobs are you issuing him? I don't have any purpose for you, actually. I can't find my purpose. You get what I'm saying? Imagine Karma coming to the establishment, right? Coming for a job. I said, you got the job too. She says, how can I make myself purposeful here? What's my purpose here? I say, what's your skills? She said, I'm kick-ass at marketing. I can close sales and close deals. I'm good at managing. I'm good at leading. Right? Guess what? I have plenty of purpose for you. It's all the same. Yeah. But for you in particular, your spirit in particular, it's two things. One is practice of self-love. Second is equipping yourself with the skills to become a very strong leader. That leadership has to be your next thing. Why? Because self-fulfillment is there.